So this video is about porous media and filtration. And this is a draft version of the video. So why do we study filtration and flow in porous media? Well, we have flow in porous media all around us. We have flow in porous media in when it rains outside and the water hits the ground. We have porous media as our clothes. We have when we clean the kitchen, we have used porous media to clear the kitchen table, paper towels. We have filters, we have membranes. You have a raincoat perhaps that is made of Gore-Tex or something similar. So we have this all around us. And you can even put a plaster on your, a band-aid on your skin that contains medicals, and those will go through your skin because your skin is also a semi-permeable membrane. So we need to know things about porous media. And so do you find any similarities between these two? If you have flow in pipes or tubes, you can say that the pressure drop looks like this. F there is fanning friction factor, L is the length, D is the inner diameter, rho is the density, and V there is the velocity. And for flow in soil, you have that the velocity, according to Darcy's law, is the constant times the pressure difference divided by the viscosity and the length. Well, these are actually very similar. And I will claim that flow in porous media is actually essentially the same as flow in pipes. So you can think of a porous media, our simplest model, as just a material with some channels in it. Circular channels that are circular in transection, all have the same size. And then you can think of the flow as flow through several small tubes. And then you can use this equation here, delta Pf equals 4F L divided by D and so on, to describe this flow. And often you can assume laminar flow in porous media. And then you get that the 4 times the fanning friction is 64 divided by Reynolds. And that gives you Hagen-Posay's law if you combine these two equations. So VE equals D squared divided by 32, delta P divided by the viscosity and the length LE. But wait a minute, VE and LE, what is that? Well, we need to think of velocity more carefully. There is an apparent velocity through a porous media, which is simply the flux in cubic meter per time unit divided by the area. So the velocity that the flow seems to have, but then we also have a porosity of the porous media. Epsilon, which is the void volume divided by the total volume, so the fraction of this volume that is available to the fluid. We also need to define the tortuosity, because the channels are not necessarily straight. They might be a bit bent, and then their length will be longer than the thickness of the material. And we define the tortuosity as the effective length of the channel divided with the thickness of the material. So the real velocity in the channel will be the tortuosity divided with the porosity multiplied with the apparent velocity. And another way to think of that is to say that the velocity in the pores must be the length, the effective length of the pore divided with the residence time in the pore. But the residence time in the pore, that's the volume of the channel divided with the volumetric flow. And then you get VE equals the tortuosity divided by with the porosity times Q divided by the total area. But that's the apparent velocity.